Many people today, even Catholics and Christians alike, wonder whether the Church is truly a divine institution. The Church is no longer seen as holy. The Church is no longer seen truly as the divine presence of God. And that is the reason why people no longer take direction, instructions from the Church, because they reduce the Church to a merely human institution, like the rest. So if I can agree with what the Church is teaching, I will accept. If I don't agree, then the Church is wrong. But this is where the danger also lies, that when our faith is no longer based on objective truth, but it depends on subjective personal preference, then where is the objective truth of religion, of what we believe? A person's faith that is purely subjective would have created God out of his own image. So the God that you have, the God that the world today believed subjectively, is a God created by man. There is no reality in what people believed in. What we believed in will also determine the way we live our life. How we understand God will also determine the way we relate, not just with Him, but with our brothers and sisters. Faith is not just based on reason alone. If faith is just based on reason, we don't need revelation. But Christian faith is basically a revealed religion. There is no way for us to believe in the Blessed Trinity if we don't believe in incarnation. If you don't believe that Jesus is the Son of God, you cannot believe also in the Holy Spirit that He sends. And it's the same for the Word of God. If we say the Bible is the Word of God, it is also based on faith. The Church advocates true love, but the world advocates false love. The world advocates licentiousness. We speak of true freedom. All these values are being challenged by the world simply because the world relies on themselves. So people will find excuses not to accept the teachings of the Church because they cannot understand it, perhaps one reason, or perhaps the teachings of the Church are not agreeable because they threaten their licentious way of life. The world today, they just want to do things their way. They want absolute freedom at the expense of the common good of society. It's about themselves, about their needs. This period of time for the Church is a time of really grace, that all these things we are going through, they are moments of grace for the Church to come to terms with the reality. And hopefully, bishops and priests also come to see the importance of renewing their own spiritual life and, most of all, be more accountable to the people of God.